Hi, have you ever had a small Arduino project and needed only few input and output pins? If yes, you can use Atmel's teeny microcontroller named ATtiny85 instead of a full-size Atmega chip. You can simplify your project, save some space, and decrease power consumption at the same time. I'll show you everything step by step. You'll need a few items. Atmel ATtiny85 chip, an Arduino Uno, a breadboard, a few jumper wires, a 10 microfarad capacitor, an LED, and a resistor close to 75 ohms. ATtiny is not yet officially supported in Arduino IDE, but some smart members of high-low tech group from MIT Media Lab created libraries for Arduino and shared them publicly. Thanks guys! Let's go to their website and download ATtiny master zip file. Open up Arduino IDE, select File, Preferences, and copy your sketchbook location to the clipboard. Now paste your path to the address bar in any Windows Explorer window and hit Enter. Create a new folder and name it Hardware. Copy the ATtiny folder from the ATtiny master zip to your newly created folder. Restart Arduino IDE. And you'll see quite a few new boards to choose from. It's time to make a programmer out of the Arduino Uno. Hook up your Arduino to the computer, find the sketch named Arduino ISP, and upload it to your board. Now we're ready to assemble the ATtiny board. Well, almost, because my partner Tina decided it's time for a break. After a few minutes of playing with her toys, we're ready to continue the project. First, take your breadboard and place the ATtiny in the middle. Connect pin 4 to ground and pin 8 to the positive rail. Take the Arduino Uno and connect its ground pin with the ground rail on your breadboard. And the plus 5 volt pin with the positive rail. Hook up the Arduino's pin 10 to the ATtiny's pin 1. Next, the Arduino pins 11, 12 and 13 to the ATtiny pins 5, 6 and 7 respectively. Put a 10 microfarad capacitor between the reset and ground pins on the Arduino board. We're done with wiring, so let's go back to the computer and Arduino IDE. Select File, Examples, Analog, Fading. And change LED pins number from 9 to 0. Go to Tools, Programmer, and select Arduino as ISP. choose your board type, it's ATtiny85, internal 8 MHz clock. Now, when you hit the upload button, the Arduino Uno will act as a programmer and upload the sketch to the ATtiny chip. Go ahead and upload the sketch. You'll probably see two red lines about page L and BS2, which you can easily ignore. It does not affect your microcontroller or the sketch you have just uploaded. It's time to check if the ATtiny works. Disconnect everything from the Arduino Uno except from +5 volts and ground. We'll use it just as a power supply. Connect the LED's positive lead to pin 5 and the negative lead to ground through the 75 ohm resistor. If you can see the LED pulse like this, the ATtiny works just fine. You can write your own sketches and upload them using the same method. Now you know how to use and program Atmel's ATtiny 85 microcontroller. If you have any questions or want to add something, feel free to write a comment below. If you like this video or find it useful, you can support me by sharing this tutorial with your friends, giving me a thumbs up, or subscribing to my channel. Knowing that you appreciate my work really helps me make more videos. Thanks for watching and see you next time.